So welcome back, Nana here, and then we are in the next day session on this Fusion order management implementation. So we are going ahead on this now. There is a small issue on this this thing now. Your ZLPX, I'll tell you what exactly is the issue now. ZLPX, okay, so click on the now. So here, there is a small issue. Your pricing segment and strategy is not exactly coming now. So for which, what you do, if it doesn't come, I'll tell you. It's a workaround. Again, it's a very vague way of doing it now. I go to the what's called order management, and then I go to the pricing and administration. And then if it doesn't come, fine. If it doesn't come in your sales orders, what you do is you go there, click on it, and then you go to the manage pricing strategy and segments, and then query yours actually. Manage pricing strategy assignments actually. Manage pricing strategy assignments, you can go there, and then there you can query yours, and then simply delete that. Fine. If you're having a problem, you can go there, click on it. I will now use the one which he has, you know, I can go the header sales all. So this one you delete it, fine, with X, delete it, and then afterwards you log out and log in and then introduce again, it gets it's coming actually. The pricing. So this is the one workaround, and then some 4-5 guys it worked actually, including Prasanna. We tried with this for the 4-5 guys, it worked okay. And then precedence, you reduce it to 9. When you reintroduce it with a 9. So lower the precedence, higher the priority, by which what happens, it may work. Fine. So is it clear now, everybody? So likewise, you try this now. Fine. If you're in the SLPX, if you're trying it now, just now I tried for Salman, it worked. And then I tried for 3-4 persons also, it all worked actually. Anybody can say you understood it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. I understood it. No, getting recorded. Now we go for the next activity on this. Now, final point.
You're not going to. People are deleting all the pricing strategies. Someone has deleted my pricing strategy. I don't know.
I told only one, and then whatever the people are doing, everything. So don't do like that. So we go there. I will now go to my login now. So let me go and log in. And then here, I will now query my order 217. 217, I'm going to query. Go there. Go to the order management, and then I go to the order management, and then I'm going to query my order 217. So 217 is my order. Enter in now. So it has now gone to awaiting billing. It has now gone to awaiting billing. So now I'm now going to perform a return actually. So to perform a return, what I'm going to do is I will now have to enable the returnable attribute on the item. Once we enable the return button will be coming over here. Fine. I'll go there and not right click, and then I will not duplicate. I will not enable the returnable attribute. And remember, when you make a change of the item attribute, it need not be collected and refreshed. Fine. It need not be collected and refreshed. We can directly go and then do it now. It will be immediately be visible on the sales order when you make a change. I will not go to the browse items, and then I will not make the returnable enabled. I'm not going to make the returnable enabled. Fine. I will not query for the D01. Enter it now. You're querying it now. So I will now open up now. I have to open up my master or find that. It is a master controlled attribute. So I'm now making it in the master or introduce the organization column also over there. Now. You go to the specifications, and then there I'm now going to introduce it. So click on the sales and order management, and then I will now enable the returnable on. Returnable is no, I'm now making it as yes now. So once when you make a change on the item attribute, now from now onwards, what happens is there is no need to collect and refresh. And let us hope that they bring it for items also. Fine. Is not a done. Fine with that. So item is no, returnable is yes. No, fine with that. Any doubts on this now? Anybody has got any doubts? I have now queried the item, and then the master shop, I am now making the returnable is yes. Good. I will now go there, drop it down. I will now give a save and close. Now this will be immediately be visible on the sales order. You do it.
Nana, just a quick question on the returnable side. Okay.
Yeah.
So if this particular item is on the master, correct? The same item is on the two more arcs.
Yeah, so one because it's the master control, right? Since it's a master control, it will now reflect on the child also. Fine, I'll now go
correct,
on.
Correct, correct, correct. What I'm going to say is here, D011, right? D012, I don't want to return that. But I
it's not possible. Then in that case, you have to change the control level to ORC level. If you want what happens, one node to be returnable and then another one not returnable, then change the control level to org level. Okay. Watch so, yeah, my 1 to 12 videos and then you do it. You have to make it as what? Now you cannot modify it at all. Fine. It must be org control to make it as a what happens, a no in other place. Now we have done it. Now we go there, it will be sensed over there. Now, fine. So we will now requery it now. Fine. You can now see the return coming up. Fine. Click on that now. You know, requery it again and go there. Click on it. 217 is the one and then entering now. Fine. You're going to requery it and then you'll now find the returnable button has now come. Okay. And then here, the return price list has not been configured till now. I don't know. I am in 20B, I think. So probably they might have configured it. You'll not make a check. You will not see the version of this about this application. In 20A also, it didn't came because I checked it in 20A also. The return prices has not come. And then we are in 20B, I think. So in 20B, so we are in 20B. So let me go on and check whether the return prices has been enabled or not. So you go there, click on it. Will now go on then give a return prices. Click on the home icon and then I go to the price list. Fine. Click on the order management and then I go to the price list. And then here, I'm now going to create a return price list for this now. Fine. Click on it. The task carousel. Let me manage return prices. It has not come into TA. We'll now see. They told that it will be coming soon, but I don't know whether it has now come here or not. Click on it. So we have a price of 2 now. I will now put what D01. Fine. I will now say return price underscore list.
So you mean to say before to 20B return price list was not there?
Yeah, yeah. 20A also I checked it. Fine. 20B also I checked it. It didn't came. We'll now see whether it has come here or not.
So how they used to manage the return?
The same price only. The return will be at the same price. We cannot have a different price for this one. Return prices.
Yeah, in that case, why they are creating a two
they have introduced it, but they told me I raised the SR some 1 year back when I was working for a Saudi project. This is under construction. It will come soon. And then now
should be 99.99% whatever the price you are selling returnable same price, right?
So now I'm choosing it as a restocking fee now. Fine, go there, click on it. And then the type is a return. Fine, go there. It is a fixed fee and then a percentage also you can do it now. Fixed fee.
So now both the price list we can do the return, the normal one and this one also?
No, whenever you return it, I'm going to associate with the strategy. You can see. I'm not putting the business unit. I will be associating the return to my strategy, and then whenever you return it, this price list will work. Actually, it has to.
Is this mandatory? Means in return?
Not
time,
mandatory. You can even if you don't give it, it will be returned only at 2. And if it starts to work, and then it will be working on the return price actually. Banana, you are selling it. If the customer is returning back, we will now give only half the price. Right? Likewise, is. So click on save and edit. Fine. This we are now given all the basic information. Fine. Click on it. Save and edit. The restocking start date. You are now given. Tell me. Yeah.
Nana, can we keep returns with the original line reference?
Yeah, if you don't give a return price, then it will be on the original price only.
Okay.
So click on right and I will not give a plus now. Fine. If you don't give any return price list over here, now, that will be on the done on the original only. Fine, D01. And then give a tab now. I have got only one item that will be coming up over here now. Fine. Click on it. And then click on create charge. So click on create charge. Go down now. And go there. I will not say it's a 2 line. I will not say the return price is, I will not give only 0.75. 0.75 for the return. And go there. I'll not manage it. So original price is 2, and then I'm not giving a return price of this now. Fine, go there. Click on it. I will not give it 8. We'll now see whether it works or not. Whenever it works, please inform everybody that return has started working now. Fine, go there. Click on it. So and I've done it. Everything. And go there. Click on it. I will now give a save and close. It's not done. And then I will now introduce this return into my strategy. Fine, go there. Click on it. I will now go to my strategy and then introduce it. I go to the manager.
No, sir, you didn't upload it.
Oh, God. Yeah. please immediately inform me whenever I make a mistake now. So D01 is the one entering now. I'm not approved it. So the price is, I have not put the return price. I'm not approved it. Buddha or Gayar? I'm not remembering things. Manage return price list. So it's a D01 and then entering now.
System is not reaching your speed level.
Click on approve. I'm not giving an approve. Okay, click on it. I'm not going to approve it. Approve is a single process, single step process. So fine, that click on save and close now.
No. Where can we see this history record?
I don't know. Somewhere I saw that some, you know, 1 year back in a training, one ticket.
So I think
this thing. Now I don't know where exactly to see it. Okay.
Go to the view. Go to the view if it is possible.
The view. Action history, record history will be available.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. And some of the
forms only you're saying. No, fine. Somewhere I have seen it now in the view record history, like that only I have seen it actually. Here I will go to the view and then you go to the columns is there. About this record. Yes, exactly. Fine. Yeah. You go to the view and then go to the about this record. It will not tell you who has created it. Created by whom And then last updated by whom is now showing yes, correct, correct. About this record. View about this record will now give you a record history of eBay sector. Good. Got it? Any doubts? I got it. Now give it done now. So I click on it and then here we go there and then you will now go to the strategy now and then I will now associate my return price list over here now. Find entry now. I'm now querying my own. I click on it, open it up and then I will now add the return prices. And go there. Click on the returns now. Find prices now. Go the return. The cost and other things will now come to you a bit later now. Find that on it. Return prices. I'll now go to the actions and go to select and add now. I'm going to add it. So go there. D01 is the one entering. We are now entering this now. And then select it and then click on OK. So by which the return prices gets added to my strategy actually. And go there, click on it. It is now added. But it is not working. I don't know whether any other thing to be done after this or not. I will now give a simple say in the return. In the prices, we have a price list now. And is a normal prices. In the prices, we have a normal prices. And then the return, we have the return prices now. Oh, the date is not here. I'll give you the date. So I'll now give a save. I'll give a save here now. It is not getting saved now. So in the prices, we have a normal prices. Go there. In the prices, we have a normal prices. In the return, we have a return prices. The price is the normal prices. If you click on the return prices, we have the return prices now. Return prices now. I save and close now. What else to be done now? Fine. Is there anything else to be done apart from that now? The strategy attached.
Nana, do you need to run that ESS job?
Which job?
The job which you mentioned is like.
That is a refresh and start is a different one now. Right. The pricing will be immediately reflected on the sales order. It doesn't have anything to be collected and refresh now. So to somebody think over it and then find it out. And then you go to the Metallica and then return prices, how to do it now, fine, go there, click on it. We'll now see whether it works or not. So you know that, and go there, click on it.
Basically, for a return, since there are no order types here, it's all orchestration, correct?
Yeah, so it is all via orchestration only, of course. Everything is via orchestration only.
So for return, do we have anything separate orchestration apart from do?
Nothing. It's all same actually. No separate orchestration for return actually. Yeah, then we are now working on a generic one. The orchestration is generic and then we are working on the generic. Okay. Now, I will not select the first line and then I'm going to return it. Fine, click on it. So, if we drop down, we have an option of returning all the lines also. I will not choose this option. I will not click only on return. I will not select the first line and then I will not click on return. I'm going to return it. So, click on return. So, here I'm going there. So, return quantity is how much? I will now say, I will now out of 10, I'm now going to return 2 now. And go there. Click on return type now. Return type is what? You can even cancel the item. The line itself can be cancelled while return. Fine, go there. Return for credit. It is only for credit memo. I will now use for return for credit with the return item. Right? This is for a credit and receipt actually. So I'm not choosing this option. The third option, return for credit and receipt. I'm not choosing it now. I'm going to click on it. I'm not going to say why he's returning it. So because the item is damaged because of it is returning it.
Go there. Okay. Nana, sorry. You say already in awaiting billing, right? So how this cancel work here now?
Yeah, see, even after you receive the payment also, the customer can return.
No, cancel one. Why the option of canceling the line terms option coming?
Oh God, I don't know. Good question now. See, it is awaiting billing. It has already been shipped. How we can cancel the item? That's what he's saying. So the item has already reached it. I don't know what exactly is mean now. It may not be exactly the meaning is not canceling the item. It may be something like returning or I don't know what exactly it is.
It may be something called like you may not... return back or you may not, the billing will be cancelled, I think.
Or something, some activity. So
this is a lab subscription. Right?
Somebody do this cancel item and then see what happens now. There is a lab exercise and then please post on the WhatsApp message what is happening on the cancel item.
Okay? No, I would suggest probably, if you don't mind, can you try to cancel and just for the...
There's all lab exercise for you. All these things are lab exercise. I will now go on and show the procedures. The remaining activities are lab exercise. Right? I'm not going to do it. Click on create order. Now, yeah, return order for a return with a credit is not going to be created. No, return with a credit, fine. Click on create order. Yeah, return order will be created. 217 is the one. 218 is a return order. 218. And then 218 will be reflecting 217, but 217 will not reflect 218. We raised SR also. Customer wanted this now. You see, the original order is coming. But if you query the 217, it will not show me 218 at all. I don't know why it's so. We raised SR. They this is the standard functionality. That is what they told me. And then they closed the SR straight away. And 218 has come. So the 218 is now showing you the return here. Fine with that. It is what it is. But here in the other one, the 217, if you query 218, was not coming. I don't know whether it is now coming or not. Fine. When I was telling about 1 year back, when I raised the SR, Oracle simply gave a reply that this is the standard functionality. That's it. They closed the SR. So this is what it is. So it is now showing you the original order over here. Now, fine with that. It is now saying, it is now this thing. So the price is minus 350. Fine. We'll not see if the price has come or not. We'll not see. Yeah. It looks like it has come. Fine. Edit the price. We'll not see. 0.75,
On what basis it is selecting this price?
One second. 0.75 we are given now. How come this adjustment has come as 0.25?
No adjustment, I think. In a original order.
The original order itself, there was an adjustment. Yeah, in the line, this line was having an adjustment. We are given a discount actually.
Yes.
Original line itself was having a discount. That is only reflecting, but the price is only same. That means what? The return price has not come down. That is the reason. Okay, so that's okay, fine. So return price has not come. Return price we are given as 0.75 has not yet come up. So if anybody knows about how to bring in the return price, please read the metallic document and then tell us. We will know, learn from you. So it's not, and I'm going to submit it now. So 218, I'm going to submit it. The return price has not come. Only we have given a 0.25 discount that is coming here now. The 0.25 discount is coming. I click on submit. In the original line itself, we have given a manual discount that is coming. I click on submit. So 218 is now submitted.
Sir, without any transaction type, how it is getting?
No, transaction type is not all required. Fine, this is not.
But how it
is
getting?
We'll come to that a bit later now. How it's all progressing, we'll not come to that a bit later. Click on refresh now, we're not going. So here, if you go to the fulfillment lines, it will not show anything at all for you. It will not show you anything. Go there. So it will not show you. So you go to the returns line. Then it is a return, fine, click on the return. You'll be having a due number. So go there. There's a return. The due number is coming in the beginning itself. You click on it now. We don't have any transaction types at this level. So it's now going to start now, fine, click on refresh. We have a return order generic process is now getting triggered now. That has got everything in it now. It has got everything in it. And so that doesn't need any transaction type at all. If you want, you can give it. But we are going to see the functionality of a transaction type over here. Now, return has started and then it is now giving error. Now, click on it. You know, see what is the error. Here, what happens? We are not set up the receiving parameters at all. So, receiving parameter will be an error. Now, I click on it. We are not set up the receiving parameter of this one.
That should come by while we are receiving.
No, here itself it will not check. Fine. You must set up the receiving options for the inventory org. So and so. Inventory org is having an ID. You know, fine. So we are not set it up. And then what happens is not coming. So let us now go and then set up the receiving options. Fine. It will be on the duplicate. So before interfacing it to inventory, it sees whether the receiving parameter is set or not for this org. So since it is not set, it is now throwing an error.
Nana sir, can we put the direct return order?
Whatever it is, the receiving options is a must now. Fine. Everything is going to come by a gate actually. A direct or a standard inspection, everything will be coming by a gate for which what happens is the receiving options is a matter.
Nana, how it took 217 order automatically or you referred while creating
it? It is automatic. While the do is progressing, it checks for this now and goes and checks for it and then it's not throwing an error that this org which is mentioned on this now, fine, it is not having this. Fine. It's not having it. So that is the reason that what happened, not shown you this error.
So if multiple items have been shipped on multiple orders, how it will select automatically?
Multiple lines on multiple orders. So I'm not able to know. Can you?
No. You told when you selected RMA, when you created RMA, the reference order selected automatically, right?
Yeah. If it is going to be, if all the lines belong to different org, I don't know. Fine, what will happen? Fine, it will not throw a partial error also. If 10 lines are there, 10 lines are getting shipped from 10 different warehouses, and then if you say return all, and then if let us say 516 is not having receiving parameters, I don't know how the error will be coming. You just make a check of it. D011. And then go there. Click on OK now. Fine. So all these things is R&D.
Nana sir, the message there was related to inventory.
Receiving receipt, parameters.
Not the AR receipt, right? That's
not inventory AR receipt. It's not AR receipt. We have not gone to the AR at all. Now. Fine. We are in the inventory.
No, the message I am just confirming.
Yeah, the message is only receiving options is not set. That is what it is. You just again run the video, it will not show you no fine click on it. I will not make it as a none now fine click on it. All the mandatory parameters are now set to this no fine click on it. I will not make it as a standard as a protein and go there. So here I'll now go make the generations automatic and then make the type as what numeric and then I will now give the next number as 1000 now. And then go down and then here what happens, you go there. Here RMA reciprocating, I will not make it as a standard now. So I will not make it as a standard now. So I'll not make it as a standard. And then go there. So this is only not required now. Fine. Go there, click on it. And then click on save and close now. Fine. RMA receipt routing is standard actually. Standard receipt. And then that's okay. The receipt number is 1000. You given now. Fine. Go there, click on it. I will now give a save and close. Now the receiving parameters of this org is set now. Now we will now rewind the workflow actually. Fine. Go there, click on it. I will now go there, click on refresh now. We are going to what rewind the workflow. Go there, click on it. So we will now recover the process. Now. Fine. Recover process. Recover process will now run again. Now. The workflow will be running again. Now. Fine. Click on recover process. We are now given an order orchestration recovery manager role is now given. Now. The error recovery manager role is being given. And then the read access is also given. So it is now refreshing. Fine. Click on refresh now. Now it is now start. It is not started actually. Now once you rewind it, it will now the X mark will go away and then it will now again run on this on the workflow. on the orchestration plan, because again, no, I can want it now. I'm going to go there.
Like if I want to check the workflow status, the way we do
I don't know.
Is how there to, a policy? Is it,
no idea at all. How to check the workflow status? We have a workflow diagram and all, and Eve is not fine here. I don't find any diagram here. No diagram is available. So click on refresh. Return receipt has now started.
Just so recovery it, Dana. Click on done and click on done and recovery it once.
One second, okay. It's not got in awaiting receiving. It is now going to the awaiting receiving. Fine, click on refresh now. It is not going there. So let us now go there and then receive the 218 now. Fine, go there, click on it. We'll now go there, click on done now. We'll now go and then return it. RMA return, we are going to process now. And click on it. We'll now go to the supply chain execution and then here automatically go to the inventory management and then I'm going to make a reserve. Drop it down and then choose this now. And then go there, drop down and then go to the reserves now. I'm going to the reserves. So I'm going to the reserves and then I'm going to process the receive expected shipments from the customers actually. And the RMA number is what? 21. If you give a tab, automatically it will now pick up now. If you give a 21, it will automatically pick up. I click on search now. It is there. 2 level 1. I click on it. And then select and then click on receive. 21 is there. I click on it. And then you now click on the show expected quantity from the customer. It's not 2. So in the transaction lines, you click on the show receipt quantity. It will now show you 2 now. I go on it. And then click on create receipt. We are now creating a RMA receipt now. I will now say the shipment number is so and so, the packing slip number is so and so. And then give all these informations, fine. It will be very useful for the analysis later, actually. Fine, when you take a report on this, it will be giving you a lot of things. So give meaningful information over here. And then click on submit, by which what happens. The gate receipt is now made for this 218 now. And then the number will be 1001. So we are given 1000. So the next number is the GRN number. So this is known as a GRN number, goods receipt number. Okay, and click on OK, and then I'm going to put away this now. And click on that now. And then go there, click on it. I will now go on the door, put away. Fine, put away. And since it is a defective item, we have to put away this into an expense supplementary. And since I have not created it, I am now receiving it as an asset actually. Fine, whether I click on it. I have now select it and then click on a put away. I am now going to put away. After the gate receipts, we are now going to put it away now. Fine, whether I click on all the quantities. I will now put the supplementary as what. Normally, it will be an expense because it is not a company's asset actually. It is a defective item. So you have to have an expense supplementary over here and then do it now. Fine. So for this exercise, okay, fine. But you do an expense or asset, it will accept. Fine. But the general philosophy is what? Receiving it on the expense. The put-away transaction is now created, but now the sales orders will not progress at all. In EBIS, while you're shipping it, when you ship it, the send shipment advice automatically runs and then it interfaces to the what's called order entry. Whereas in a return, we only have to manually trigger that. There is an equivalent program there now. Fine, that on it. So there is an equivalent program of a send shipment advice now. So send shipment advice, there is an equivalent program that you have to manually run. Fine, go to the schedule process, fine, go click on it. I'm not going to run it manually. Fine, click on it. It's called send receipt confirmation. So go there. Send receipt confirmation. Give it a send receipt confirmation. We had to run it manually. So I don't know why they have kept it manual. This is not going to automatically get triggered actually. The send receipt confirmation, we had to run it manually. Then only the sales order will be sensing the return now. Fine, whatever you return. It will be communicating the feeder system actually. Fine, go to the organization is what D011 and then you tap now. And then logistics provider, logistics service provider customer. If you have a third party logistics, you have to provide it, otherwise leave it as is now. Fine, go there, drop it down. And then here we have to choose do now. The do is a one, fine, go there. So we have to choose what? The do. Fine. Order orchestration and planning. That is the one you have to read. And the receipt number is 1001100 and then you tap now. And it will be picking up 1001 over here now. The receipt number is not coming, fine. Drop it down and then choose it now.
We can settle this program every five minutes.
Okay, fine. Yeah, he's saying that, but without a receipt number, you have to program it.
Remove the receipt, you can settle every 5 minutes in order to run that.
Yeah, and when schedule it every 5 minutes so that what happens, there is no need for it to manually run it now. That's good. That's a good observation. So once when this completes, it will be communicating back to the order entry that the return is now done. Send receipt confirmation is not running. So once when it runs, then it will now go to the awaiting billing status. So we are now returning it at a 3.5 now. 1.752 is 3.5 is the dollars is the return now. So I'm running. Normally, when you ship it, the send shipment advice will be running a notify feeder system concurrent now. So that notification feeder system will be updating it. But here, this concurrent itself is updating it. No notify concurrent is running. While you're shipping it, your notify feeder system's concurrent is running. Here, upon running this concurrent, it doesn't do, but it gets updated on this place. And click on save confirm with that. Awaiting receiving. Now it will now go to the billing actually. It is now delivered now. The invoice process has started now. and then it will now go to awaiting billing. It is goes to awaiting billing because we have not done the rapid implementation. Rapid implementation has already set up the AR now. So because of which it will now go to awaiting billing now. So this is a credit memo. It has now gone to the awaiting billing now. We'll go there and see it. So we have not completed these steps now. So, you know, then we've done it. And then we have now created order now, find the line struck on the receiving parameters. So we are creating a credit model in the line studying on the receiving parameters. So receiving parameters are not set. So set the receiving parameters and then do it now. What happens? Go to the manager receiving parameters and do it now. So 54th step is completed. So we'll now come to the 54th one. Send receipt confirmation. I'm now running it now. Fine, it's not done. And now we are into the 56th step. Now we are now going to run this one now. Fine, we have to open the period and then we have to set up now. This one I will now show the error now. Let me first of all open the GL and receivable period now. 57th step is what? Opening the GL and receivables period. We go there, let us open it up now. So it is not done. So you now go there, click on it, now open the period. Click on it. Now go to the home icon and then I go to the GL now. I go to the general accounting and then go to the period close now. Fine. I go to open up first of all the GL and then afterwards receivables. So click on the period close. And then you can now see it's never open now. July is never open. Fine, click on the general ledger. And then you're now seeing your ledger coming up on the top now. And then here, go there. What is the first period? Is January 19th. Fine. We are now given started the calendar with the January 19th start now. Fine. Click on OK. And that will be open now. First. So it will be opening up. And then afterwards, we can even give a target date of August 20 also. Fine. Go there. Now the concurrent is running. And then we are refreshing it. And then once when the refresh is completed, you can now see the period gets opened for January 19 actually. The period gets opened for January 19 now. Click on it. Click on it.
So what's the program, Nana, for this open the period?
There's no period opening at all. You simply click on open period. Go to the actions and then I will now open the target period. Fine, click on open target period. And then here I will now drop down. I will now say up to August or September. Fine, September 20, I'm now opening it. Fine, all the intermediate periods will be opened automatically, just like in EBIS also. We can even give a target period as well. So after having opened the general, we will now open the receivables period actually. We'll now open the receivables period now.
Hello, Nana, Shiva here. What is the role to for the recover process?
Recover process, order recovery, this thing, find something. You go there and see something. There's the one. You go up now. Order orchestration, error recovery manager. If you don't give it, you cannot recover it. This role is a must. So it is not done. Fine, click on done now. Order recovery. So now GL is open, receivable is not open. Somebody asked what is the program. You simply click on it now. Right? Simply click on it, it will open this. So simply click on it. And then here is now asking for the first period. Fine, go ahead, drop it down. Now here there will be a problem. It will not show from September afterwards October. Now it has to show me January 19. Now tell me what I have to do now. You tell me. It's not showing me January 19. It's not showing after September I'm opening it up. It is not showing me the future period. It has to show me January 19. Tell me what I have to do now. I'll do a simple one now. And tell me anybody.
Search?
No.
Any calendars?
No. After GL, whenever you make many major changes, what do you have to do?
Log out and log in.
Exactly. Fantastic. Whenever you make any changes, what happens? You log out and log in. Then only the changes will be sensed by the system actually. And any major changes, you have it as a habit. It may not be, here it is a prerequisite. In some cases, it is not a prerequisite, but it is a better practice actually. Now go to general accounting and then I go to the period opening. Log out and log in. For any major changes, you do it now. Click on receivables period. Now it will not sense this. Go there. So, you know, say first period will be coming. Go there. January 19 will be coming. Drop it down. Mandichi. You got it. So click on OK now. Fine. I'm not going to open it. So click on yes. So it's not done. Fine. Go there. Refresh it and then it will be getting open now. The period will be getting open now. Then afterwards, you can open the target period directly. Now I'm going to run the auto
invoice. You need to open costing period.
Not necessary. Only another way is you push it to costing, that is not required at all. If you're going to push, then it is required. Otherwise, not required. Go there, drop it down. I will not choose this. I will not go to the August.
So you mean that without pushing to costing, you can push directly to GL?
Exactly. No, not GL. But if you want to push it to GL, it will now go as an uncosted entry now. Fine. That is another thing. You have to cost it and then do it now. Fine. What are the sequences of activity you discuss the financials? No? Financials will tell you what to do first and then what. Now I'm going to push it to GL also, and then it is an uncosted transaction. Rather, I don't know how it will all work actually. Fine. I'm not
but that's not the correct way. Right?
Correct way actually.
So why we need to push the uncosted transaction?
Yeah. You had to open the costing period also. Fine. Costing period, you cannot open it from here now. Fine. It's a different place where you had to open, not from this place actually. So now you can now see both are open now. So this activity of opening the period is now complete now. Any doubts on this now? So we are into this place now. We are now complete opening the period. So we are not doing it fine. But if you want to open the 57th step is now complete. Now I am going to import it. It is going to fail because this receivable system options is not having IVO at all. So this is not having IVO. So I will not show you a failure. And then afterwards, I will now add IVO into the managed receivable system options. Let me done the import order invoice concurrent. Okay. Take off it. And then you know, run the input order invoice concurrent. I click on the home icon and then you go there. I go to the tools and then go to the schedule process and then run the import order invoice. Click on schedule process. Now it's going to fail.
Is it like auto invoice?
Order invoice master. Exactly. So import order invoice, the one thing you have to have now. I'm not going to find the import order invoice. This is not going to fail. So go there, the business unit, and then transaction source is not this one now. Fine. You have to use the do now. Fine, you have to use the do. Fine. It is a distributed order orchestration. That's got everything built in now. You have to use the do. Fine. The transaction source is do now. A distributed order orchestration. And then we'll now what happens? We'll now run it now. So if you leave it blank, it will be running. Otherwise, what happens? You can even give the from sales order and then to sales order. But fine, go there. We'll now give 2007 and then 218. So you can even give the range of sales orders or other criteria for pulling it into the EAR now. So click on submit now. Fine, by which you are now pulling it into EAR now.
Yeah,
so the reason that has not already reached the interface tables of AR now, I'm now going to bring it from interface table to base table now. Once when the status is awaiting billing, it has reached that state of awaiting billing, it has now reached the interface tables now. Tell me, somebody is listening?
No, Venkat here. Yeah. I have one question.
Yeah.
If I wanted to add new transaction source in the
talk to AR team, fine. When you want to have your own transaction source, how to bring in, because this works only on the do actually, I know that. As far as import is concerned, when I learned it from one of my financial guy, Arya, for your training, this is sufficient. That's what he told me. I didn't know much about it actually. Thank you. So click on the republish output now. Fine, click on the republish, and then I'm going to see it. So Venkat's question is good, but I don't know the answer now. When you want to have your own imported transaction source, how to bring in? That's what he's saying now. Click on PDF. I don't know. Save it as a PDF now. So click on save, and then you know see that you'll be having an error. So click on it. What happens? It's not saying it is not rejected as 6 now. How come it is 6? 3 lines of ours and then 1 return line. There must be only 4, huh? Why it has come as 6 now? Come on, what is it? 6 lines it has written. The one first one. Item validation organization, that is what it is missing now. Right? Because of it, the Munil submitter is also coming. It doesn't matter. So this is the first one. This is the second one now. This is for $20 now. Fine. $20 is what? 2 means what? We are given 10 line. Line number 10. Line number 10, and then line 1 is return actually. It is now giving a manual discount. Okay, this is the one, is a manual discount. Right? Line 1 price is 20, and then the manual discount is 2.5. And then afterwards, what happens? It shows you the 40, and then it shows you the 60. Fine, go there. And then the return. Fine, go there. That is why what happens is not coming. And then again, the credit memo for 0.5 also. So that is why 6 lines have come. Got it? Huh? We have 3 plus 1, 4 lines. And then this is a manual one, the credit memo for a manual one, as well as the credit memo for a manual adjustment. Fine, manual adjustment, manual discounts we are given. So everything is normal. So we have got 6 lines which has got stuck on this now. Fine, go there. Let us now go and then set up the receiving receivables. Fine, go there. Click on it. Since we have run the auto invoice automatically, so what it does is when we run the what's called your rapid implementation do not have an inventory at all. So what you have to do is we have to go there and then now we have to add the inventory on. When the rapid implementation has already created the receivable system options, you go there. So if you go to the manage receivable system options, the system has already created during rapid implementation. Go there. We'll now go to the thing and then we'll now go there. So rapid implementation has already set up the receivables options. And so at the time, inventory org is not created. And so we only have to manually add after the inventory org is created. So click on it, paste it over now. Enter it now. So manage receivable system options, I'll now go there. Click on it. I'm not going to have a look at it now. Go there. I will now put the search now, find D01 and then give a tab now. The tab is not working, you drop it down, choose it. Whereas here I got only very less number of business units it will be coming, or you have to make a search and then do it. I'm doing it now, fine. Click on it. I'm doing it. And click on query now. I'm not querying it. Go there, no coming. I go there, click on it. And then here I have to add this. I'm not going to add it. Go down and then here the item validation organization has to be added. That is the error now, fine. D01 is the one. The master org has been added. The IBO is a must for. I have not told you about what exactly the IBO fund. The remaining entries, everything the system has populated. All the accounts, everything is as populated because of rapid implementation. Rapid implementation has done everything. And so what happens? There is no need for it to do anything at all. Fine, was that on it. And then give a save and close. No, mute all. Somebody is muted. No. If you are speaking, you can see. Now if I go on and run it, it will now pass. No, fine, was that on it.
There is a one measure came, no? Unit of measure.
Units of measure is the same thing. Once when IBO is coming, the units of measure will be getting installed automatically.
Okay.
So import order invoice.
In EBIS, we have like once it has been interface, we can see a form like providing the sales order number, and we can see like that.
I have seen it exactly. In EBIS, we can very well see the interfaced lines actually, and then we can even correct the interface lines there itself. I know that.
Correct.
You can even make the corrections. Here, I don't know that physical is there or not. I'm not sure about it. Anybody?
I think a financial orchestration. Shall we check there? I'm assuming it will be there, right? The financial orchestration.
Maybe. What Subbu is saying is that the editing of the interface transactions maybe on the financial orchestration. That's what he's saying. Maybe.
No, we can see from it is receivable, then there's a billing option.
No, what he's saying? The item has reached the interface tables now once when it has gone to awaiting billing. But then here in EBIS, you can very well edit that line.
I'm talking about the same. It is now we have the line which is already in error.
Yeah.
Go to the receivable. There is a billing option and there is an view interface line.
Okay.
So he's saying in the receivables billing, there is an option for view interface lines also. And then you can correct it.
But we can't see it from the screen. We can see it from the Excel. We should have that FDI. It will be exported.
You have to export it and then correct it in Excel and then bring it back in. You're saying, nah?
Yeah.
Okay. Somebody,
I'll check it.
I will have a look at it. So in the receivables billing and then view the interface lines and then export it to Excel and then make a correction and then bring it back in. That's what he's saying.
Yeah.
So you can't resubmit nothing for that. Import order invoice. I'm not again resubmitting it actually. Thank you. This time, no change in the parameters actually. Thank you for this. No, I'm not resubmitting it actually. Now this time it will not succeed for both. So we have six lines now. Fine. Three of our shipment line, one of our return line, and then two adjustment lines actually. Manual adjustment lines are coming as two different lines now. So all the six lines has to pass, and then it will be getting coming to the base tables now. So once when it completes, but I'm going to see the report now. So the execution report is now running. So once it is completed, we will now have a look at it. So it is now succeeded. Fine, go ahead, click on have a look at it now. Drop down. And then I click on republish. Export to PDF. Click on save and have a look at it. So now you can see all the six lines have got selected and then all are processed successfully. So there is no rejection at all because of the IBO is the only problem. Now go down and see now. Fine. It is now saying how many credit memos, number of transactions, number of invoice lines is 2 now. Fine. It's 3.75. Number of invoice lines is 2. What is this here? 2 means what? I don't know. So 4 invoice lines. Fine. You just see it may be a quantity, not a quantity, not 10, 20, 30. Oh God, I don't know what you just study this now.
The credit memos are 2 and invoice lines are 4.
Oh, number of credit memos is 2 and then number of invoices is 4 actually. Fine. It is the quantity of number of lines. Okay, fine. It's okay. I got it. So now 4 invoice lines and then 2 credit memo lines. So totally 6 lines. Good. Number of transactions 2. Okay, fine. Good. So the net value is what? $114 is the one which the customer has to pay us now. Fine. Go click on it. It's not showing everything and then nothing else is there. Good observation. Now we'll now go to the receivables and then have a look at it. Any doubts on this now? So it's what number of lines actually. Okay, got it. Close it now. And we'll now go to the
standard order and RMA order together into the receivables.
Yeah. I brought 217 and 218 together now. Actually. I gave the from number as 217 and then the to number as 218. So both of them have grown here. So you can even selectively bring in whatever way you want, you can do it. If you leave it blank, all the things will be brought to the interface. Whatever is there in the interface lines will be coming. You go to the receivables and then you go to the what's called, you go to the billing now. In the billing, he's saying that there's one return lines or the interface lines. That's what he's saying.
It's an open interface.
It's an open interface. No, have a look at that. Click on it. No. He says there's an open interface is there now. Where is that? Anybody? Okay, who is this now? Who told?
This one, manage auto invoice lines.
Yes. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Manage auto invoice lines. If you go there.
Exactly, yes.
Manage auto invoice. Oh, God, it will be downloading it now. Okay.
Yeah, saving it.
And then that one you have to do it now. Fine, good, good, good. So manage auto invoice lines will not show you the interface lines. That is what he's saying now. Fine, use it now.
Okay.
Good. So that shows automatically saves it and then you have to do it now. So manage auto invoice. Now, I don't go to the manage transaction, then have a look at it now. Fine, click on the manage transactions. You know, have a look at it now.
Find error also in a manage auto invoice lines.
Okay, fine. Yeah, because it has to be set properly. Now, AR is not fully set. So, there are so many things. The reference number, I will not put the bill to customer over here. Now, fine, D01. In eBills, we had to query on two fields now. Here, it is not required. So, one field is sufficient. Here, on the bill to customer as well as the date, you had to query here. Once one is sufficient, now, fine, click on search, it will not show you the number. Now, you're going to process this also. I'm going to click on it. Well, see, there is one thing. 6003 and 6004, I'll make a notepad. And then I'll not note it out. Notepad. So, I will not say the transaction numbers. No, right?
Nana, I have a question. How these transaction numbers sequences generated? Can we have a control? Like, if I
anybody,
want to have...
Anybody from... can we control the numbers? Is the question of Salman now. Fine. Anybody can answer him.
Like, I want to have the delivery number or the shipment number as the invoice.
The delivery number or shipment number as your transaction number. Fine. I don't know how to control it now. And anybody, if anybody knows about it, fine, please post on the what's called WhatsApp message.
That's a part of a batch, auto invoice batch setup, right?
It may be. So, auto invoice batch setup, he's saying, fine, click on it. So, we have now got this now. If you open up the 6004, is a credit memo. If you open up the credit memo, you can have a look at it now. 6004 is a credit memo. We can have a look at it, but what exactly has come now? So it now shows you the credit. So you want? So it is a credit memo for $3.5. It's a manual adjustment. Remember, it's a manual adjustment. And then give a cancel now. So the return price is not working. So go there, click on 6003 and then see it now. Or there may be a procedure to put the return prices into picture now. Fine. If anybody knows it, it will be. So the first item, fine, go there, click on it. So it is a, there I've got this one. And then the one main one is a manual adjustment is now coming. I have separate one. So 10 quantities, 20 quantities, and then 30 quantities are three different lines. And then the manual adjustment is coming separately as a separate line actually. Only on the first line, we are given the manual adjustment is coming. So total is 117.5 and then go there. So net payable is what? 114, na? Something it came, na? 114, I think. 114 is a net payable to the customer. 117.5 minus 3.5 now. It is 114 is net payable. Got it now? 140 and paper. We'll not go there. Now we are going to process this. We'll not process this. So now we have done it and then what happens? The line is closed now. The sales order line will be closed now. The sales order activity is now complete now. We'll now go to this place now. Go there. So the sales order line, if you go there, click on it now. Now if you go there, open up the 270 now and go to the order management and then you go to the order management. Let me query it now. I will not see this. So the activity of a the CSR is now complete actually. The activity of a CSR is complete. And so he will now be closing this line. Or this will be automatic in many cases now. I will now go to the order management. So the closing, you will now run a concurrent automatically. Fine, go to the 217. I'm going to go say, now go to the query now. So they'll be closing this. The line would be getting closed now. The lines are closed. So that means what? The system has brought into the base tables. And so the CSR's activity is complete. Now the revenue recognition team has to collect the payment from the customers. Now what he will do is, he will now close the header also. He will not close the header also. So what happens? His activity is totally complete. In our company, in the Saudi company where I was implementing it, every day evening, he has to report how many he has closed on the day. He has to give a report and then how many is not closed, for which he will not give an explanation that there is a problem in the warehouse or something like that. Fine, he will not give an explanation. The purchase department is not, he's a buy and sell, so they have not purchased the item. So you will not give explanations for all the non-closed lines. So that's how they will be having a manager meeting. So we'll not go there.
Is there any report for that?
There may be a report now. Fine. They used to go with the report. I have seen it now, but probably it may be a standard report or otherwise a custom report. I'm not sure.
Nana, sir, another thing like
close. Forgot the concurrent here. Close order header or something like that. Some concurrent name is there for closing the header actually.
But normally, Nana sir, this will happen triggered every month.
So the frequency varies. That's what he's saying now. Not every day.
No, sir, EBS is Oracle standard. It will take care of that.
That's what
update
my
question, sir.
What is it?
Update and closure.
Update, yes, exactly. Update. Update.
The below we have, Nana.
Yeah, update process.
Last one.
Yeah, update process. Update close the one and go there. So the update close here, sort of fine, go there, click on it. And then what Subbu is saying that it will now close the header order only in the month end of fine. That frequency can be
seen. That's a standard function on EBS, Nana, but not, I'm not sure about in
cloud. Here you can run it as a concurrent of fine, go there, click on it. And then interval hours, I don't know what is here, you know, maybe it is 1 year. So go there. So header, I'm going to close.
Nana sir, in release 12, you know, we have workflow background process, right? What is the equivalent program in Fusion?
No idea. That is all do only. Everything on the workflow background process, everything is do. Not only release, it is there from a very long time actually. So this will now close the header if all the lines are closed. If all the lines are closed, it will not close the header. If lines,
hi Nana, Venkat here.
Tell me.
Yeah, I have one small doubt. We are getting the sales order number as 217, right?
Yeah.
Let's say I have a requirement for export sales orders. I have to get the sales order numbers as 2 for the domestic sales orders.
I know about numbering, but I don't know. I will not teach the last, because what happens if I give a numbering, everybody will middle out, and then you will not be able to create the next sales order at all. So I will not show about the numbering. So you reserve the question during numbering actually.
Okay. And for the same, we can generate the invoice numbers also, right? Like for the export orders, invoice numbers.
Somebody is saying. Somebody told, see, please communicate on the WhatsApp message, and then all of you will be getting an answer. Now, if you refresh it, you can all see the header close. So the header will close only when all the lines are closed.
Nana, the customer acceptance setup, like in EBS, we have, right, pending.
Very, very tough. Very, very tough. Customer acceptance is very tough now, fine. I will not say it is not even come. It is there, but it is very tough. One of my students told me, gave me the script for this now, fine. It's very, very tough customer acceptance.
Okay.
Nana Venkat here. I have one more doubt.
We have given up time of give a time of 0 now. Fine, let me run it. But then I'll now given the time as 1 hour now. Fine, let me come and give a time of 0 now. So go there, click on it. I'll put the header now. And then interval hours is, I'll make it as 0 now. After 1 hour only, I think probably now we'll not run it now. Fine, click on it. So we'll now see whether it immediately closes or not. Yeah, tell me your questions now. Tell me.
My question is, in the EBS, usually when the order get imported from other sources, we'll use to capture the source there from where it is coming, in the DFF or in the other tab. So in the Fusion, where we can find that one?
I don't know. Fine. How the imported orders can be seen in which one. OPS is the one which are using now for our order systems. Maybe for imported, some other plugins would have been configured.
Mm-hmm. So not only import, like even if you create an orders within EBS also, it will say the online orders, right?
Got error. So like that. The program got error.
Yes.
The program has ended in error. In the
other step, we can see usually as internal and the regression number. Okay.
The program has ended in error. Somebody make an R&D and then see, but how to run it now. Fine. I give a 1 hour. So after 1 hour, again, I will know, make a check. Probably this will be running now. Fine. I give a 0. It's not giving error now actually. So see to it that there is some mistake somewhere now.
So. And Nana sir, one thing, the CY here, actually, if you go to the sales order form, could you go to the sales order? Okay, if I want to, can we see only these many fields, or if I want to see freight charges or something, carrier?
No, so some new columns you can add, no?
You no header also same thing?
Yeah, maybe. In the lines also, we have it. Now. We have to go to the lines region.
Okay,
we
okay.
View column, we can very well. We are now going to add a view column on this. Now. We are going to add one more column. For our ship set and fulfillment set, ship set, arrival set and fulfillment set, we are going to add one more column now here. I will not show you at the line level also, we can add it. The view and then go there and then column adds. We are going to add it. So we can add the columns like this.
Okay, no, got it. Thank you.
Next thing is what I'm not closing it. I don't know what is the mistake. I'm fine with that. Keep the header parameter, header gets closed.
Nana, what is the equivalent of order organizer here?
Order organizer, there is no such equivalent at all. You have to go and make a simple search now. There's no order organizer equivalent. Now, we'll now create a bank now. Fine. We'll now go on.
Nana, sir, Manu here. Can we close individual order at the order level itself? Is there a function?
That is not showing only as a header. Nah? It is not showing me the order number. Is it showing or is there any parameter? Make a check now. Fine. If the parameter is the order number, then you give the order number.
No parameter for
order. No parameter there. Yeah, it's not showing closing everything. Whatever lines are closed, it becomes eligible for a close actually.
Okay.
No parameter there. Now, let us go there and then create our what's called your bank now.
What are the sales orders eligible or the complete
sales order?
Which are the sales orders are eligible to close?
All the lines closed are eligible. If a sales order got 10 lines, if all the lines are closed, then it becomes eligible for a closure.
Yes.
Okay. So, manage banks will now go on and get our bank loan. The next
activity. This concurrent is mandatory to close the order, or it will close automatically month end, same like an EBS.
I don't know. Fine. Subbu, he says whether it will now close automatically or not. That is what his question is.
EBS, it will be Akbar. EBS, it will be close automatically.
Yeah, I know. EBS, it will be close. Yeah. I'm asking the same here.
Maybe.
I'm not sure about here. I think we need to wait for the environment. Also, is not stable, right? Wait for a month to see.
Yeah, in EBS also that will close by workflow background process. Like we have a parameter, right? OM order.
Yeah, exactly. That's correct. We can customize the workflow.
That's what my question was initially.
Yeah, this bank code, maybe that ABAN code or something like that. Nah? I'm not sure about it. What exactly the bank
99% EBS will not touch that seated one. That will be closed automatically.
Yeah, exactly.
People are least worried about that order header closing. Mainly, everyone will worry about the line closing.
Line closing.
Because that will give more worry about that interfacing and then the closing activities. Invoice valuation match report, right? Costing. It will give a problem if you are not closing the lines properly.
Yeah, you're correct.
You can discuss now. I'm not only filling up the parameters now. You can very well watch. It's a simple one. I'm now creating an address now. And the state is NY. And that postal code is 10020. So I'm not giving a bank fine there. So the bank address has been given now. The bank's address has been given. I'm not given all this. You go to the contact. I'll now say, who is the contact person? I click on person. I'll now say, who is the contact person? I'll now go on the day. And I'll now say, it's Ananta 1. And Nana 1 now. So there will be on the branch, there will be another contact person. I'll now make it as what last name as what Nana 1. Go that on it. And then go on the phone numbers and go to add something on it. I'm going to add a phone number now. So the contact person's phone number and I will find the work phone and then area code. I will now say 44. Fine. 2345678900. Fine. Let me on it. And then I'll now make it as a primary. If you click on it, that becomes a primary contact number for this. I will not give the bottom one. So create bank account contact and then the contacts address I'm going to give it now. So initially we given an address of this now. Fine. I will now say it's a D01. Fine. The contact address. It's 2 now. City is New York. Initially we gave the bank one. Now we are giving the contacts address. Go there. The 10020. Is a 10020 if I go there, click on OK now. So you're gonna, and then you can even add a mail, email also. Click on plus now. So purpose is work now. Fine, go there, click on it. I will now say it's a me@u.com. And that's it. Fine, go there, click on it, and then give OK. So the contacts, everything has now been given. Now, fine. I have now given a contact to over here. Fine, click on OK. So it's a simple one, and then go there, keep everything. So the bank's address has been given as the contact details, and then afterwards the contact address is also given. Now. So click on save and close. This completes the bank creation. Any doubts on this now? The bank is now created. It's our bank. Remember, it's not a customer's bank. It is our bank. Implementing company's bank. You'll be giving the taxpayer ID, everything also. Fine. Click on save and close. It is now completed. So we have completed the bank creation. D01 starting. The bank is now
What's the purpose of this bank now?
We are going to receive it. Now fine. In our book of accounts, all the receipts will be uploaded on this bank actually. Go there. We'll now go and then take the bank branch actually. Click on them. We'll now go on that. The bank branch. We are not going to create. Bank branch. So the bank has got a contact. The bank contact person is also having contact. Fine. Two contacts. We're given. We'll now create a bank account. Go there. Bank is what D01 and give it tab now. So the branch name. Fine. Go the branch name. I will now say New York branch. D01. I will now say it's a New York branch. New York branch. Fine. Go there. I will now give alternate name also. Then fine. Go there. Take it. Alternate. Branch name now. I will say underscore alt alternate name, and then routing number is a 9-digit number. That is what they told me. So it will be a 9-digit number. So if you give a mistake on this, now fine, it will be throwing the error somewhere. That is what my financial guy told me. It is a 9-digit number. Is a routing number now. So go there and then do it appropriately. Take a copy and put it in the description. Now. Description and then go there. So bank branch number type. Fine. Is a chip enabled or not? Fine. There are so many other things for the EFT and other things. This you have to fill up. Since I don't know, nothing is mandatory, I'm not filling it up. So chip enabled bank, basically, that's what you're saying. And drop it down and then on the address, I go there and then click on plus now. So I go there. I will now say it's a D01. Fine. It is a branch. Here, see, it's a branch contact. Say 3 now. Branch contact 3. I'm going to click on it. I will now say it's a New York. And then the NY. Go there. It is a 10020. I go there. Click on OK. So by which what happened? You know, the address now. And then I'll go there. Click on the contacts now. So this branch has got address, and then the contact who is sitting in the branch also will be having a contact. Thank you, Anantha. I don't know. So it's Anantha 4. Fourth one. And I will not give. It's a Nana 4. The fourth guy is a contact actually. Nana 4. I'm going to click on it. I'm going to click on the phone numbers for this contact actually. I'm going to click on it. I will not say it's a work now. And then I will not say some number. And go there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It doesn't validate actually. Click on it. I will not make it as a primary contact now. So click on it and then I will not give address for this contact now. Go there. It is.
Nana, what about the customer bank account?
Customer bank account also can be created. I don't know how to do it now. Somebody knows it. How to create the customer's contact. Customer's bank account can also be very well done. Yeah, we are learning the skeleton part of AR actually, not everything.
Why? Because once return happened, we need to...
We can create the customer's bank account accordingly. Fine, you can very well do it now. So that is very much possible. And then since I don't know that much, fine. I learned this to some extent now, fine. Me. one@u.com.
So this is for cash receipt application.
We are, what you going to do is a cash receipt application or anything which is not going to be recorded. If the customer is giving a check also, you're not going to record the system. That route I'm going to go for. So click on it. Fine, that's it. So we are now completed the branch account creation. Branch is now created. Thank you. Seven close. Everything is starting on D01. So that's very easy for us now. Fine. Go there. Commit. Fine. The branch is now successfully created. Now go there. So now, what happens? You know, we have the bank account, branch account now, the account, now, fine. Our account in the bank now. We are going to have an account, so that account I'm going to create. Now paste it over, you know, manage bank accounts. Account. So bank, branch, and then account. Our account we are going to create. Click on first now, we will create the account. We are going to create an account. So branch is what? D01, and then you tab now. That will be the account number I'm going to wait now. Right? So I will now say 9876543211. This is our account number. So account name. I will now say it's a Nana Consultants. I am now implementing this Oracle ERP, and then it is my company. Okay, fine. It is not a customer's company, remember. It is my company, and then we will know. I will now give it 9876543211. So the implementing company's account number has to be here now. Account name has to be here now. Currency is what? US dollars. So the legal entity name, I'll now put D01 and give it a tap now. The legal entity coming now. The account type. So if it is a checking, it is a current account, it is a savings of that. See, checking is a current account. I will now put the what's called my account name in the description column now. Click on it. So if you try to save, if you don't access the business unit, it is accessed actually, it will not save at all. You can say it will not access at all. It will not throw an error now. The business unit is not associated at all. To your bank account, we had to associate a business unit now. Fine. The changes were saved. Come on, it is not saving. I don't know. Previously, it used to throw an error now. Fine. Click on it. I go to the business unit now. Fine. Business unit access. I'm not giving it. If you don't give it, it will not save at all. I don't know. It's not saving properly. Previously, it used to give error actually. And I was working. I will not give a D01 and then give a time now. No coming. So, automatically, the system has picked up because of auto accounting the cash and cash clearing. Fine. Everything is not required. Fine. There are some things which are required now. I will not, you don't have to put in data. The auto, what's called your rapid implementation has populated so many accounts, and then they are coming up over here while you're associating a business unit. And then go there. Payment document categories. Fine, go there. So the payment document categories are applicable only for payables and not for receivables, actually. This is applicable only for payables. No, fine. No need to give it to all. When you do a payables, you have to have the payment document category. Whereas receivables is not applicable at all. Fine, click on OK now. Go there. Click on it. I will now enable it only for receivables and not for payables. You go to the general over here now and click on the general. And then here, the cash account, everything account has come on. The additional alternate account number, all those things are there. Contact if you want, you can give it now. And I'm not doing now. So some important accounts has already come. The cash and cash clearing has already come. So that's it. Our account is created. If you go to the controls, there are more controls on this now. Fine, go there. Cash management controls. And then the security, all these things you learn from AR team. AR will be giving you all these things now. You can even secure by bank. Fine. If you enable anything properly, it will ask secure bank account by users and roles. No, fine. So maybe if you don't give it, automatically they'll be giving all the errors. So this is it. Fine. Our bank account is now created. And click on save and close. Now we'll go for the next step. Now fine. Go bank. Now what happens? We now have the, go to the manage receivables up here. So in many systems, the earned and then the unearned accounts will not be there. So we have, if it is not there, we have to create it. We'll go there. Manage receivables activities will go there. So somebody is please mute all of your mics now. Somebody's mic is on now. So please mute. And then whenever you want to speak, you can open up and then speak. I click on done now. Come out of it now. go there. So I will now go there. Manage receivables activities. I'm going to read. So go there. Is the one or is the one? Okay. Manage receivables activities. Click on this now. Manage receivables activities. And if you make a search, if I go there, click on search now. You have to have one for, or I'll now put D01 and then go tab now. I'll now put the business unit and then click on search now. If you search for it, you have to have one entry for the unearned and the earned account. One earned account and then unearned. Maybe the rapid implementation has already put it on. The rapid implementation has created the earned discount and then the unearned discount. The earned discount means what? Let us say we are now giving 2 by 10, net 30. That means what? The customer can enjoy a 2% discount if he makes a payment within 10 days time. Otherwise, he has to pay the entire net on 30 days. That is called 2 by 10, net 30. But let us say he is now making a payment on 15th day and then he is asking for the 2% discount. So since he is a good customer, your boss may agree, okay, giving it. So if you give a discount which is beyond the payment terms, they are known as unearned discount. Right? If it is as per the one, it is called earned discount. So the rapid implementation has already created these two entries with the appropriate account actually. So no need to worry. Otherwise, we have to manually create. We have to give a plus and then create it manually. The earned and unearned discounts, you have to create manually with all these things. Otherwise, give a cancel. So it is already. So this activity, manage receivables activity, is not required because we are not going by a rapid implementation. We'll now go for the next one. Manage receipt class and methods. This is the next task. We'll go there. We'll now go to the manage receipt class and methods. We click on it now. We are now going to make the manage receipt class and methods. So click on plus now. Fine. So here we have to normally name it as what? This one, cleared receipt class. No, fine. That is the name they normally give it. That means what? The customer is giving you a cash and you don't want to make an entry in the system about who has given and all. So this is what it is. Or the customer is giving a check. You are going to deposit in the bank, but in the Oracle systems, you don't want any entry at all. So a cleared receipt class will now bypass your customer accounts, customer bank accounts, and then the customer deposits whatever he is making. And let us say he is giving a check. If you are going via that route, that is called what happens, a confirmed receipt class. If you are going via a confirmed receipt class, then we have to enter all the details of his payments actually. He might have made an electronic payment or a wire transfer or even a check. So all those things has to be entered to the system on a confirmed receipt class. On a cleared receipt class, what happens, nothing is required now. Fine. We are now simply acknowledging that he has paid actually. And then make it as a manual, no remittance directly. Fine. For this, now, this is the options now. Direct remittance and then manual. All this. These are the three options for a cleared receipt class. So click on plus now. Fine. I'm going to make a receipt method. Now, fine. I will now give the name. I'm not putting the same thing now. And the printed name also, I'm putting the same thing. So it's not done. Let's go there. Click on which account we are now going to deposit this. He is now going to give me $114 now. Remember, $114. So click on plus now. And then I'm going to deposit this in this place. So click on plus now. Fine, go there. I will now put my account. Fine. This will be credited to our account in the system actually, not practically. Fine. In the system, this account will be credited. You go there, give a bank. And then the branch will be coming. Fine, well, everything is coming. Account number is what? Drop it on. There's only one account number. If you have multiple account numbers, it will be coming. Fine, well, this account will be credited. The cash and all other accounts are coming automatically. The unearned discount is not coming. Fine, go ahead, drop it on. And then it will come. Unearned discount. And then here, earned account. This is the mandatory fields. If in the previous step it is not created, we have to only create manually. Then only you can populate over here now. Remember. The remaining accounts are auto-populated because of your rapid implementation. And that's it. So the create remittance bank account is now complete now. So click on save and close now. Fine, go there. So now we are now completed what the account and then the receipt class method has been completed. This is a cleared receipt now. Fine, there is a confirmed receipt. There is a big topic which will be covered in the AR now. Fine, and the confirmed receipt. If the customer is now giving you, let us say, a check number of 1234, you will be entering the check number with a bank branch and then the amount, everything, etc., in the system itself, and then you'll be having a record of those things. They are called confirmed receipt class. On which case it will not be manual or no remittance. It will all be changing now. And learn that confirmed receipt class from the AR team now. So now we are going to have a simple thing that our bank will be automatically deposited with this. Whenever I receive 114, what happens? Our bank will be receiving it. And then how we have received it, either by cash or by check or wire transfer, that we are not mentioning on a cleared receipt class. So click on save and close, by which what happens? This activity is now complete. Now the next activity is what?
Nana sir, we are talking about rapid implementation, it will be popular, but when the ECGG instance, we didn't populate that. So how it is going to work?
You have to manually do it now. In the ECGG, what happens? You have to manually do it now. So you are unable to run the rapid implementation there. Everything is manual. Actually. You have to go and then search for it and then do it now. It's all completed. Fine, go there. Receipt, and then this is now come. Now we go and then apply the receipts. We are not going to apply the receipts. We go there. We are going to apply the receipts. $114 is the one, and then we have got two invoices now. One for 117 and then one for some 3.5 minus now. Fine. So we are going to go to the receivables and then we are going to apply the receivables. Fine. So next time to the receivables, account receivables and then create receivables. Receivables, account receivables and then create receivables. We are going to create a receipt now. Fine. Click on it. Now give it done now. And then that will be going to a bank directly. Click on it. Now. Fine. Go there. Come on. I will not go to this place. I will not go to the receivables and then go to the accounts receivables and then create receipt now. Receivables, account receivables and then click on create receipt now. We are not going to create receipt and then post it. Click on it. It is a cleared receipt. Remember, it is a cleared receipt, not a confirmed receipt. Click on create. In a cleared receipt, we only say that I have received this much. How I have received, I am not going to. Business unit is coming. Fine, goes like everything is coming now. Fine, goes like, and then the remittance back. Fine. If the customer is coming, then order will be coming now. Fine, goes like, I will not give the receipt method. Now. Fine, drop it down. Receipt method. You know, go there. Drop it down. You know, see, is a B01 cleared. It's a cleared receipt now. Fine, it's a cleared receipt. Once when you put it, the receipt class is now having all the bank details. Everything is now getting populated. The receipt class is having our bank details actually. Everything is now getting populated. Receipt number. I will now say 1500. Fine, the number. So this is the receipt number we are creating in the entered amount is 114. My entered amount is 114. Fine, was that 200. So we are now giving a net of what happens your invoice and credit memo. Fine. Invoice is for 117.5. The credit memo is for 3.5. And so we are now going to make a payment of only the payment received is only 114 now. Fine, was that 200. Now we go down, having filled up everything, it is the customer's detail now. Customer's bank details also you can give now. Even though it's a clear receipt, we can even record the customer's bank also over here now. We will not be giving the check number on the things or wire transfer on the things, but at least we can even record the customer's bank details also. Now we are going to apply this against our invoice and credit memo. Fine, go that, click on it. You go down, add open receivables. So after having put the amount, fine, click on the add open receivables by which what happens, we are going to apply this document. And then I will now on the add open receivables, I will now query on my customer name now. Fine, D01 in your tab now. So I'm putting the customer name over here now. So click on the one coming. Go that, click on it. Now choose this from this page. Give a search now. it's not coming. Come on. It came up. Took some time. It came up. Click on OK now. So that will be populated. And then click on search. It will now show you both the invoices. One invoice and credit memo are eligible for application. Oh God. The credit memo has not come at all. There may be some mistake which I have done.
No, Nana sir. Invoice amount got clubbed and it is showing 117.
6003, the 6004 is not coming here. Once again, I will now add it now. Fine, go ahead, click on it. I will now add the 6004 also. Go ahead, click on it. Let me query the 6004 and then add it now. Click on add now. So that get added now. 6004 is my reference number now. Fine, let us now try to manually add it. So give it done now. Fine, it is already applied now. Click on, so it's not done now. Go ahead. 6003. Click on add open receivables and then I will now try to put the reference number over here now. Fine, click on search transactions. Where to put the 6004? Tell me. Receipt reference number 6004. Let me query. 6004. I'm querying now. I click on search now. To do query by customer and I query, it's not coming. As I said, here also it's not coming. Let me remove this and then query now. So click on it. No query. Oh, it's not coming. Come on. Receipt transfer.
No, sir, left side you have a checkbox. No?
Include credit memo.
Include credit memo. If you select it last time itself, it will come. Nah? Fine, that's what you're saying.
Yeah, just select.
I will now remove this number. Fine, I have not done it. And go there. I will now put the what's called the customer number now. Fine, transacting customer numbers. Oh, God. Last time had I ticked it, it will be coming now. Fine. Good observation. Fine, click on it. Had I included credit memo, it will come. Click on search now. I'm not putting it over here now. So somebody when you're doing it, you put the tick mark and then see it now. Fine, click on okay now. I will make a search. I want 1004 coming up now. 6004, I want it now. Fine, click on search now. 6004 has to come now. Come on. Vandichi, we got it. I will not choose this now. I go there, click on. I will not choose only this because already that is added now. I click on it. So 6004, I'm adding it now. So that is for minus 3.5. So 114 is the net amount actually. I click on done now. So we are now applied. Fine, these two things are going to be applied for the $114. That's it. Now, what you have to do is, since it is a cleared receipt class, you should not submit now. That is what my financial team told me. Had it been a confirmed receipt class, we can submit it. But since it is a cleared bank, you have to do it manually only. He says that the receipt has to be applied manually. So you drop down and then submit and apply manually. He asked me, Arey, simply do this. No, if I don't ask too many questions, that's what he told me. So I just learned only this part now. You have to apply it manually. And submit manually, we have to do it. For a clear receipt. For a confirmed receipt, you can even do directly. And that's it. Fine, go there. So click on this. The 1500 receipt is now made. Fine, click on save and close. No, fine. You can now see entered amount is this. This is not. It is now applied. Save and close. So this is activity. Now, if you go and then see your bank accounts and other things, everything will be showing you the $114. So I don't know how to see those things wrong. There is a lab exercise for you. And then if you want to see the 1500 receipt number, you know, go there and have a look at it now. How to manage receipts? You go to the manage receipts and then you know, look at the 1500, it will show you. Fine, what is the receipt number? What is the receipt number? Everything is there. Receipt number is not there yet. Come on.
Nana sir, under
receipt the number starts with.
Oh, starts with, okay, 1500. 1500 and then click on search now. It will not show you the receipt number. And then you can also see the receipt, which is getting applied now. Fine. If you click on this, what happens? It does not apply to our bank account now. Fine. It's just there in the system now. It's not showing you the cleared on. It's a cleared on actually. Fine. Go click on it. And then the zip details is not showing you. Fine. Go there. Nothing is shown here. Our bank details is also not shown here. Additional information is not showing here. Because it has to go into a bank now. Fine. It's not showing anything. History. If you click on it now, fine. $140 history. It will not show you the cleared account. Fine. Go there. Conversion rate and all. So click on the activity and then see. Fine. Try to make an R&D on this receipt now. Fine. And then see why I'm not able to see the bank details over here now. It has got applied to our bank only. Because
can I click a show more button on the top?
Oh, show more button. In the show more button may show now. In the show more customer and remittance bank. Bank. Fantastic. Fine. It now shows you everything now. Our bank account, remittance bank account is not shown over here. That's it. Now we have to create the account now. Fine. So the activity in the receivables is now complete for a or happens for a cleared receipt, not a confirmed receipt now. For a cleared receipt, you're completing the fine, give a cancel now. So we are in the show more, we are able to see it now. Fine. Now we have to go and then do the create accounting. So this is not done now. Fine. Now run the create accounting for this.
Nanas, like why did like functionally like logically wise like clear receipt then confirmed receipt?
See, clear receipts, you're not recording any of the customer's payment. He might have made a given a check payment or a whatever a bank transfers or electronic or wire or whatever it is that we are not recording in the system at all. So our bank account gets automatically updated to $114, but it will not show you from where it has come. But had it been a confirmed receipt, everything has to be entered. That is what he told me. There's a big process. So I learned only this clear receipts. So try to learn the confirmed receipts from a year man now. Anybody here who knows confirmed receipts how to process? I will also give a session to you so that whatever you can even contact it actually. So click on create accounting and I go there. I'm in this main place on the accounts receivable area and then I click on it. I will now click on create accounting. I click on create accounting and I'm going to create accounting. So once when you click on the create accounting from a receivables area, this create accounting is for what? Is a create receivables accounting. Automatically it is coming. And I go there. I will now go in the detail now. I click on the detail. Is a ledger now. I go the process category. Can leave it blank now. So create accounting is yes. Accounting mode is final now and then is okay. Accounting report level is detailed. I'm going to click on it and then transfer to GL and then everything. I'm posting with GL also. So Subbu was saying you should not do it without doing the costing actually. There is one thing called import revenue lines from AR to costing actually. So only after that you may be doing it. I'm not sure about it. Fine. Subbu has raised a very good point. Without bringing it into costing, the revenue lines has to be imported into costing and then from there you have to push it and not from here. No. That's what he was saying. But no real clear idea.
Because the reason is, Nana sir, if you use some SLA customization, right? Uh-huh. There are some accounts will go in the SLA, then it will go for costing. From there, it will move to
GL. Normally, you will know what happens. Push the revenue lines into costing. And then afterwards, you from the costing, you will now push it to GL. So you can even contact Subbu whenever you are doing it. Thank you, Consulting Online, by which the create accounting program is running. So we'll now, you wait for 5 more minutes. Let us now complete this activity. Now. It's not running. So you go there, go to the monitor process, then what happens? You go there and then click on refresh it. The create accounting and ordering. Create receivables accounting. It is not running. So it will also generate a report for you. It will not generate a report and give it to you now. So we are now giving you an introduction to AR now. Now go and then make a deep dive and then you'll know more, much more. So create accounting is running now. Then finally, we are now going to create the what's called your the trial balance. And remember, Oracle system can only create a trial balance. And then afterwards, you want to have your profit and loss and then your balance sheet. You have to take it to Hyperion or otherwise you have one more utility in Oracle called So with that also, we can do it now. But Fusion will not create your balance sheet and profit and loss. It will not do it. It will not stop at the trial balance. Afterwards, you have to have the external Hyperion system or otherwise some other thing that he told me, I forgot.
Is there a separate license for that, right? No, sir, it's not integrated.
You have to have a license for Hyperion. But if an Oracle system is there, that is that may be coming as a bundled one, I think. For creating the profit and loss and balance sheet, there is one Oracle something he told me, yeah. That may come as a failure.
Cognos report?
Huh? EPM? Oracle EPM?
No. Some other name.
SmartView?
Huh?
SmartView?
No, not SmartView. There is one standard utility in Oracle available for preparing the profit and loss and balance sheet. He told me, but I forgot. So import journal child is running now. So once when this come meeting. Now the child, the journals are getting imported into GL actually.
I'm sorry, is it FRS reporting?
I don't know. FRS, he didn't say that. There's much of a big name here. Something he told me. It is not FRS. Oh, you are saying yes, financial reporting system, na? Maybe, I think so. Yeah, something like that only he told me. Financial reporting system, I think.
Yeah,
financial reporting system. Or financial reporting center or whatever it is. Yeah, he told me. This will now help you. That may be coming as a free license for you for creating your profit and loss and balance sheets. So if you learn AR, I will teach you. Do you want me to learn AR? Actually, what happens, you need to have a commerce knowledge. Otherwise, going into financials is not correct at all. Because there are so many terminologies. And then if you know, you're not having a commerce background, you will not be able to teach properly. That is the reason I'm not touching any other financial models at all.
So people should always pay credit debit. And they'll speak always numbers also. 4 series, 5 series, 6 series numbers.
So credit accounting execution report is now complete. Fine, click on it and then I'll have a look at it. I will not see the output now. Fine, click on republish the output now. So you're going to go there now. Click on it. So click on it and then go to the exports and then go to the PDF now. So click on the PDF now. And then I'll now save it. You know, have a look at it. So the create accounting is now completed. Fine, go there, click on it. Now have a look. Create accounting is not. So it is now credit memo one number, invoice one number, receipt number. What is this receipt? What is this receipt here? Journal entries are 3 are transferred now. Oh, it's the payment receipt, na? $114 he has paid now. So number of documents, it has now created 3 documents. One for the credit memo, one for the invoice, and one for the cash receipt or payment receipt actually. The cleared receipts now. So it's now showing you the revenue now. Fine. Revenue to receivables is the one which is now hitting it actually. Revenue to receivables. I don't know what are the final entries for this now. So it is now showing you this now as far as the journal entries for this is now concerned. For the credit memo. So credit memo 350 is the one. Revenue to receivables now. So here it is revenue to receivables again. Fine. $117. And then here unapplied cash to cash. And 114 to 14, unapplied cash. So finally, cash account is hit now. So in a transaction, what happens? The cash account has to be hit now. So that is what it is. So the create accounting is now completed. Now we'll now go on and have a look at the journals. Journal, it has now created. Fine, click on close it. Then close it now. Now have a look at the journal. Click on it. Now have a look at the journal. You go to the GL now. GL, and then you go to the journals. Go to the GL and then journals, and then we know have a look at the journals now. Whatever it is created. So GL journals is the one where what happens, you can now see the journal entries over there. Another 5 minutes now, fine. We'll now create the trial balance and then we'll now call it a day now. The final activity. So go there in the monitor process, what happens now coming, then I'll go there. We will now run the concurrent also parallel. Now go to this place. There is a 68th step now. Fine, go there. General ledger trial balance report. Now. And take off it and then in this place, you know, paste it over here now. Paste it over here. And then click on OK now. You know, see this. Now having a primary entity name, entity ID, I think nothing is required. Oh, but I'm now worried about this interval now. Fine. I don't know what exactly is now. So click on submit now. Fine. I don't know about the entity name. Update or update or cross sensor. So click on the schedule new process. And then here, what happens? Give a go now. Enter in, generate. Ledger trial balance now and click on OK now. Ledger close okay. Why it's coming like this? Yeah, fine. Right, I will now open up one more tab again. Duplicate it. Click on it and then I'll now go to the tools and then go to the schedule process. Click on it. I will now click on schedule new process. It will be coming as a blank line up and go to the click on paste now and then give a tab. General trial balance report. I'm giving you a tab now. Click on OK now. You know, see what are the parameters. Oh God, so many parameters there. I will now go there. The data set is one. And then the ledger is this one now. And then the ledger currency is USD. Fine. The currency type is the total entered or whatever it is. From period, I will now say, drop it down. I will now say from, oh God, why other things are not coming? So click on search now. I had to have this now. So go down. I will now say from June to July. And June to July. I will say from here. I mean, the two period is July now. Oh, it's not coming.
Selected 19.
Oh, 19. God.
19.
I now selected 19. Okay, my brother. I have not selected 20 now. Click on search now. Click on search. So I will now say September is now open. June 20 to July 20. June 20. I will not give the two period as July 20 now. July 20 is not going on. Account level, I don't know. It's not mandatory. I'm not leaving it as another. I will not go there. Okay, fine. Data trial balance is detailed. So we're now going to create the submit the trial balance for this now. Fine. That is the final activity in Fusion now. So it's not running. So in the meantime, what happens? You know, let it run now. We're not running. Now go back on this place now. In this place. That is the manage orders. Monitor now. Monitor. Journal entries. So click on this task carousel and then click over to go to manage journals. You go to the manage journals and then let them query the journals, whatever has got created in this place. So accounting period equals to, I will not make it as what, July now. So I will not make it as July 20. I go there, click on search. It will not show you all the journals which are created in the GL actually. So click on search now. It will not show you. So it has now created one credit memo, one receipt, and then one sales order invoice. This is for 117, this is for 114, and then this is for 314. So these are three journal entries which has got created in GL actually. So they're all automated. So it will now come as an imported one. If you click on it, what happens? You can now see you click on it. It is an imported, it is not a manual journal. You click on it, you can now see it is an imported journal. So July 20. Now have a look at it. It's an imported. So type is what? Where is it imported? Yeah. So showing the journal imported, import created actually. I'm not showing as imported. So it's now hitting the debit and credit with the appropriate accounts now. Right? Rapid implementation is point to populating all the accounts. All the accounts are populated by rapid implementation. Now, you'll now go to the manage processes. Now, you'll now see the trial balance now. The trial balance has succeeded. Will it give any report now? The trial balance, this is the report now. The report now. So, trial balance, general ledger trial balance report is the one. It'll now go on that. Republish it and have a look at it now. Export to PDF now. So we are going to do it now. And now save it. Now show now. Click on it. So this is not showing you the period now. So this is the trial balance now. Fine. They normally run the trial balance for even the test systems also. They will not run it and do it now. So it says what this account, your year beginning balances, net balance, nothing, and all these things are coming. So the period activity is 114 now, ending activity, net balance over there now. And then it will not show you this thing. Fine. Account wise, that is not showing you. This account, particular account. Account segment is 1210, for which this activity is now 117.5 or 1210. And the next is what? Next is account segment. What happens? 1210. So 1210 and then 1240. It shows you the account description also. So it is also 114. That is 117.5. This is the net, I think, maybe net point. That isn't coming. And then afterwards, what happens? So see 4110. 4110 is now, is the credit memo actually finds the borders. And then the net one is now showing as 114. And then there are three accounts which are hit actually. The total for balancing segment is what? 01. For the 01 company, the total transactions in this period activity is 235. What is this 235 error? I couldn't understand this. How come the 235 came in now? The period activity. It is now adding everything or what? 117 plus 114 plus 350, I think. Am I correct? 117.5 plus 114 plus 350. It may be the man. 7, 4, 13. Okay, it may be correct. Yes. It is the total activity. You just add it now, fine. 117.5 plus 114 plus 350. It is the total activity in this period now. That's 235 is coming. The total balancing, the total activity for this one is not showing you. The total for the company, all these things are not showing you. So with this, we complete today's session of what happens, completing our OMT AR. Any doubts? Good then. There are no doubts. We will now continue tomorrow. Obviously. So, can you see where you can stop? Is it interesting? Yeah. The intro to AR. Have you got an idea about it now?
You reached your target 68.
Yeah, 68 target I have reached actually.
Nanasar, out of this, like from the previous session, actually the ECG instance, I created the on hand and it's when I submit.
I saw you were on hand. We will discuss a bit later on. You see, I have corrected some errors now. We now still have errors actually. We will not discuss a bit later.
Okay, sir.
Madri has now done everything on the ECGG actually.
Yeah, ECGG accounts is not default.
There are so many customizations they have done. We will also, if it is working, we will now recommend it others. Others, please don't touch it till Badri makes an R&D and then make it workable. Now, fine. It is not working actually fully.
Oh my God. So many customizations. You're giving sure responsibility.
Subhi is also going to make a try now. Fine. It's not throwing some errors actually. Something they have done now. Fine. Please don't touch ECGG till we get a clearance from others. Any other questions on the today's session now?
So the status before awaiting billing at the header level will be shipped.
And then it will automatically go to awaiting billing if you have done the rapid implementation. Otherwise, it will be shipped only with the error in revenue lines actually.
Okay.
In the billing lines, it will be showing an error.
Okay, sir.
Because AR is not set now, fine. We had a manual set there. I have already shown you the manual setup of AR now. But again, on Akbar Ali's one, it has got failed actually. Fine. I don't know what the mistake I'm making now.
This managed receivables activities, is there any comparative topic in EBS?
I don't know. I learned from OnlyFusion that there are two types of managed receivables activities. One is what? One is a cleared one and then one is a confirmed one. That is what he told me. I don't know what is the equivalent in EBS. Anybody? The cleared and confirmed. There may be something equivalent. EBS is a big one when compared to Fusion. There will be something comparable for the cleared and confirmed. There will be something. You put the question on the WhatsApp and then somebody may answer you, okay?
Nana, there is a list of errors status now, like in EBS.
Yeah.
We are not using the auto allocate, create auto.
While we are doing it, I have also released two errors also. I've shown you while shipping. You just watch those records. We can even very well release. We are going to do some more activity on shipping. No? We are going to do some more activities.
Okay.
Watch my shipping record that I have released. There are three lines there. One of the line was released to Arrows, and then from there, what happens? We have done it, I think, probably. I'm not sure about it. Anyhow, we'll be doing it again.
Okay, Nana. Thank you.
Any other questions on today's session now? I've taken 15 minutes more because I want to complete this in one go now. Fine. That is why what happens? I've taken a moment of time. Good then. Fine. Bye for now, and then we'll now meet tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
Nana.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rana.
Thank you, Rana. Bye.